This is a new import 5C collet chuck for the home shop. Is it any good? Is it worthy to be here? We'll find out. Let's get it mounted. While I'm deburring this 5C collet, a necessary task if you purchase import ones, let's talk a little bit about home shop tapers. No, not the one your lathe turns because you aren't friends with Rolly's dad. I'm talking machine tapers and associated collets and holders. If you're just starting out, try to standardize on the 5C taper for work holding. Some folks use ER collets and they work just fine, but 5Cs have some added benefits. The biggest one is the inexpensive availability of soft 5C collets and the ability to buy 5C collets for all polygons. 5C is also a true workholding collet. ER collets are technically designed for tools. While you can cheat, and I have too, ER collets have a much longer requirement on grip. That is, if you are gripping short parts, ER can be troublesome. There's a lot of hate on the internet for this style of spindle. It definitely doesn't have the convenience of a camlock nose, but I really don't mind it all that much, and I greatly prefer it to threaded spindle noses. There is some play between the register on the face of the lathe spindle and the one on the back side of the plain 5C collet chuck. That's actually a helpful thing. It allows you to tap the chuck into alignment. I do that with the three jaws well on this lathe. If that doesn't sit well with you, I'd like to remind you that it's good enough for Stefan, so I'll let you argue with the German. Viel Glück. Seriously, for home shop work, it's an acceptable compromise. I don't take heavy enough cuts to move the chuck anyways. Now, there's a word of caution, perhaps, when buying these chucks. I'd recommend you getting a plain back one, even if you have a camlock spindle nose, and make or buy a separate backing plate. By separating the chuck from the mount, you have an easier avenue to adjusting for possible manufacturing errors. If it is all one piece with the camlock studs directly integrated, the only way to fix the collet chuck is to regrind the taper. So let's mount this chuck up on the 10x18 here and dial it in and take a few measurements to see how well it will do in the home shop. Right now there's about 2 thou runout. That's not acceptable. So I've left these cap screws loose. I'm just going to tap it with a dead blow hammer until I can get that as low as possible. So here I've got it down to about 5/10 run out, maybe a little bit less. So for the type of work that I do on this lathe, that's pretty good. So I'm going to tighten it down and then I'm going to put a test bar in here and we'll measure the run out on a test bar being held in a collet. So I put a 5/16 import collet in here, and I chucked up a reamer with a 5/16 shank. I'm just indicating the runout, basically right up next to the collet, and it's showing about a thou, which, for what I do in this shop, is pretty good. These collets could be out. by that much.
Next up is to mount the collet chuck on the standard modern. That requires an adapter plate. The standard modern is a D13 camlock. I'm not a huge D1 camlock fan. The taper on the nose is exceptionally short, and this standard modern uses the smallest of the camlock bunch, which probably makes it a little bit worse, but it's still plenty good enough for what I do, though. I was going to make up a backing plate. Seems to be a big hit for YouTube videos for some reason, but by the time I added up the cost of cast iron and buying the studs, I was well over what a purchased one cost. The purchased backplate didn't have any tapped holes for the collet chuck, so I set it up in the mill, centered with a dial indicator, and used my D-arrow to lay out the holes. Same setup as the import lathe here on the standard modern. We're getting the same readings. It's about a thou, maybe a little bit less than a thou. Again, this is an import collet. I don't have a Hardinge collet to test it. And these are just standard accuracy. I didn't buy high accuracy ones. They were actually a gift, a Christmas gift from a family member. So overall, I'm very happy with this 5C collet chuck. The finish on it is really good. The accuracy is acceptable for a home shop. Is it a Bison? No, I don't think so. Granted, I've never actually used a Bison in my shop, so I don't know how accurate they are out of the box. But for the type of work that I do in a home shop, if it's within a thou, fairly close, typical collet chuck type work, that's doing really well. If I need more accuracy, I can always put the four-jaw chuck on here or look at ways to tweak this even more accurate, perhaps higher precision collets. I hope to be making some parts with this thing shortly. Thanks for watching. See you next time.